What's good, YouTube? Back at it with, excuse me? You know what I'm saying? Back at it with the Mafia 2. You know, I've been slack a little bit. We back on track with nothing. I guess I'm just losing network. I ain't even do nothing. But anyway, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, because my Wi-Fi is horrible. But let's get back into it. Joey!
Joe's pleasure, pal. It's Vito speaking.
Vito, why didn't you come home last night? I was worried sick.
Mama? I didn't know you had Joe's number. And whose phone is this?
So have you spoken to Mr. Pappalardo? Find yourself a job?
Yeah, he told me to come by and see him today. Hopefully he's got some work for me.
Okay, Vito. Good luck, mio bambino.
All right, bye, Mama.
Once again, how does she got my... No, I ain't putting on no fit. No, we going out here... What? I mean, I gotta put this on, man. We going to get that job interview. Now, for real, though, can I go back to the little outfit I had? I can't walk around looking crazy. I'm trying to stop greatness.
Oh, hi there.
What's the matter? Nothing good on the radio?
Mind your beeswax, kid.
Like, is you cool? That ain't my car. The high class. Hold on. Oh, so we trying to get the A to B. Push it, baby.
Dancing the victory.
He got something going. You gonna find a way to move out my way?
We're dancing the victory polka.
And when we play, get each flag down.
Each flag down.
Dancing the victory polka,
and we will give a cheer.
Plan a rash, just a souvenir.
And we'll
each girl kiss the boy she kissed goodbye. And they'll be marching out to Fairmont.
I'm Richard Foxberry for ECNR with some more wonderful music on the way that's almost as sweet as Swift Lemonade. Why, it's the only beverage I reach for when I need a lift after a long, stressful day here at the radio station. There's more music coming to you right now here on Empire Central Radio, ECNR.
Skies ain't gonna cloud no more. Ain't gonna fail. A bluebird by the toe. Rainbow by the
fun up in that. Ah, got me. Come on now. Of course I'm gonna get the job. Look presentable.
Close the door. It's windy. What do you want?
Yeah, I'm looking for a Mr. Papalotto.
Oh, yeah? Why?
My name's Vito Scaletta. My old man used to work for him, and I'm looking for a job, so I came here.
Well, you're in the right spot, sonny boy. Federico Papalotto at your service. You can call me Derek. I think I remember your dad. Good guy, but drank like a fish. What's he up to these days?
He's dead.
Oh, well, y'all gotta go sometime. Right, Steve?
Sure, Derek.
So you need a job, huh? Well, you're in luck. We just got a new shipment to unload. Steve will show you around. Now scram, my steak's getting cold.
Follow me.
You got me clocking in at 9 to 5 for real? I should have wore something else. The suit. I thought the suit was gone. Give me a little bonus.
Load this pile of crates onto that truck. When you're done, you get $10. If something gets lost or broken, you get nothing. Start now and don't take all day.
All right, sir. Are they for real? Leave when you had enough.
Oh, yeah, this is gonna be a lot of fun.
Don't worry about it.
Who the fuck wants to move boxes around all goddamn day?
Don't even worry about it, coach. I'm gonna get my money's worth. Need a 100 ball when I'm done.
Jeez, all this for 10 lousy bucks? You gotta be kidding me.
We clocked in, we clocked this dedication right here. I know there's many playthroughs and everybody done walked out. We here. We are here. You might as well click off the video, because I'm come back a little bit.
How can these guys stand this? I'm doing this for 5 fucking minutes, I already hate it.
I clocked in. I'm ready to work.
know what? I don't need this chicken shit money.
What you mean? I'm trying to get right. How you stopping my shine? I'm just trying to get right, man.
Hey, you done?
Yeah, I'm done. And you can keep the $10. When I said I needed a job, I didn't mean slave labor.
Whatever. Get the fuck out of here, then. Don't show your face around here again.
Yeah, don't worry. I can make 100 times more working for Barbaro Incorporated.
Wait, you said Barbaro? Joe Barbaro?
Yeah, so what?
Shit. Nobody who works with Joe would carry crates for $10. What the hell are you doing? Come with me.
Not what you know, it's who you know.
What now?
Well, this one don't like manual labor.
What the fuck?
Said he works with Joe Barbaro.
Bullshit. Who wanna load crates if he works with Joe? You'll have to explain this one to me, sonny boy. What's your story?
Well, my mother wanted me to come talk to you about an honest job, but I need some real money, so this ain't gonna cut it.
Them women, they're all the same. Right, Steve?
Sure, Derek.
She doesn't want you hanging around with Joe, right? My mother was the same way. Look what become of me. Union boss. I got the whole fucking waterfront under my thumb. So how's Joe?
Pretty good, I guess.
How'd you meet up with him?
Oh, we go way back to the old neighborhood. I just come back from overseas, and he's putting me up until I can get back on my feet.
Listen, you gotta understand, a person in my position has gotta be careful.
Certainly.
So you won't mind if I give Joe a call, right?
Nah, go ahead.
Where'd I put his number? Hey, here it is. He might not be home. That wouldn't be good. Hi, Joe. Hey, this is Derek. Listen, I got this guy here. What'd you say your name was?
Vito.
Vito. He's looking for a job. He says he's a friend of yours. A good friend. I just wanted to check with you first. War hero and all that shit. All right. Thanks, then. I'll talk to you later. Sorry, pal. I had to check you out. Joe says you just come back from Italy. You must be able to handle yourself. You want to make a little more money? I got just the thing. The guys here at the port are supposed to pay a monthly fee to the barber, but half of them never cough it up. I need someone to give them a little nudge. $10 a man.
What if they don't need a haircut?
Well, then you'll have to convince them otherwise.
I see. What if somebody makes a fuss?
Then you kick the shit out of them.
Well, let's say you teach them a lesson that doesn't require that they miss work. You got it? Which is why Steve ain't doing the job. Right, Steve?
Right, boss.
Collect at least $150, I give you 50. Just for walking around, taking it in the Sierra, meeting new people. Easy fucking money, eh? What do you say?
Yeah, hey, it's better than lugging crates around.
All right, get going.
You creep up on me again. You really will be bald. I'll do it to you. You too. That little peep shooter you got under this little... have your state code.
I'm here to collect the fee for the barber.
Hey, what kind of game you playing here?
The kind where you pay what you owe when you don't get hurt. You got a problem with that?
I got a problem with you. Now get out of here before I kick your ass.
Number 17. I forgot he was fighting. Damn, just straight into it, for sure.
Here's your fucking money.
Yeah, glad you decided to reconsider. Hey, pal. Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
Yeah. I must have forgot or something.
Next time, try to pay on time, okay? Thanks.
Oh, you must have forgot.
Hey, Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
Sure, here it is. I don't want no problems.
Don't leave it until the last minute next time.
That's me, dog.
Hey, pal. Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
Look, asshole. I'm not in the mood. Why don't you get out of my face before you get hurt?
No can do, pal. Derek wants his money.
Derek can kiss my ass. What's that fat fuck gonna do? Have me killed?
Hey, you said it, not me.
Why don't you give it a try then, asshole?
Must it be golden gloves or something? Like, what? What was the purpose? Could have had a normal conversation like everybody else. My swing look, buddy. We'll be here all day. We'll be here all day. Like I said, he supposed to be going to the club. It was a jab, tap, jab, do it to him. This is your king?
Okay. Anybody else got a fucking problem with paying for the fucking barber?
Slump his head. Look at him. Just look at him. Hold on, hold on. Can I tag some more people?
This guy already paid.
Alright. Paid in who eyes?
I got his money already.
I hope so. Jesus Christ, bro. Let a man work.
Here's the money, boss man.
Good job. Here's your share. I watched you take care of Bill. You were good. Steve damn near got his ass kicked when he tried that. Right, Steve?
Right, Derek.
Here's a bonus for sorting him out.
Thanks.
The guy's been a real fucking pain. Now get out of here, kid. I gotta be getting back to business. Say hello to your mother for me. Tell her you got yourself a job as my new assistant.
Yeah, will do. I'll see you later.
And Vito, I almost forgot. Joe called. He wants you should meet him at Freddy's.
I said something like, you know what I'm saying, came here. It was really the suit. It's the suit. Is you crazy?
Yeah.
With a suit like this, man, I can work anywhere. Yo, is the tires flat? Am I tripping? I think I'm tripping. Now it's time to go cross country to go talk to somebody. To go another cross country to talk to another person. I'm already known.
Game of God.
I'm assuming on the hardest difficulty, the cops get upset and you run a red light. Because there's no way. Like, I just did that and they didn't get upset.
Hey, where the hell you been?
I came right over as soon as you called. What's going on?
You remember the wise guys we used to see when we was kids?
Yeah, why?
The guy we're meeting here is one of them. His name's Henry Tomasino. I think he's got something big for us.
Yeah, no shit.
Yeah. We're done with the small-time jobs. It's time to make some real shkadol. Here, he's coming. Don't say nothing stupid.
Hey, Henry, how are you?
Hiya, Joe. It's the guy?
Yeah, this is Vito, an old friend of mine.
Good to meet you, Henry. You vouch for him?
Absolutely, Henry. Trust him with my life.
Okay, listen. I got a job for you. The money's good. I need gas stamps. They're worth a fortune now because of the gas shortage.
Where can we get them?
Any office of Price Administration.
That's a federal government agency. Isn't that a little risky?
What? Too much for you?
No. Just trying to think of how we can pull it off.
It can't be that hard. The stamps are kept in the safe at night, but the keys are probably around here somewhere.
You got somebody inside?
Yeah, one of our guys. His sister works there.
Can she help us out?
Ask her yourself. Her name's Maria Aniello. Here's the address. Tell her I sent you.
All right, what about the safe? What if the keys aren't there?
That's your problem.
What's the job pay?
I'll give you $600 for 10,000 gallons worth of stamps.
Okay, we're in.
No, I need Vito to do this alone. I got another job for you, Joe. So? What do you say, Vito?
Yeah, sure.
Hey, and don't forget to take a piece with you. You never know what's gonna happen. Better to be safe than sorry. I got beef.
Wait. This isn't some liquor store stick-up. I want this to be a clean job. If you kill anybody, your cut drops to a third. Gabish?
Yeah, I got it. No problem.
Okay, when you're done, you come back in, we'll settle up.
All right, I'll see you.
Good luck, Vito.
If I kill anybody, my money gets cut down.
Yeah, so long, buddy.
Well, third. I'm telling him, I'm going in Rambo. Is you done? I'm going in there, Rambo. They better have a save. They better have a checkpoint for me. I'm going in there, Swanton bombing. I got a barbershop in the game, but like, I can't get a lineup. A little boozy fade. Ha ha! They think I'm about to open the door for you. Crazy. Am I tripping? Okay.
Okay, let's go. And take it easy behind the wheel, all right? I seen the way you kids drive these days. All right, kid. The place is locked up pretty tight at night, so you gotta get into the back.
They keep the back door open at night?
No, but the basement window usually is, so that's how you can get in. You're looking for the safe, right?
Yeah, how'd you know?
Lucky guess. It's on the top floor. So's the director's office. That's where the keys are.
Okay. So I go in through a window around the back, then head upstairs to the director's office, right?
Right. And be careful. There's guards in there at night. Don't let them see you.
Like I said, I didn't tell them, bro. I'm going in through the front door. Knock on it. They open the door. Hey, who are you? This is... I just end up having an uproar. Rambo. No, I don't even knock her. I'm kicking down the door. So let it be known what type of time I'm in. Blast everybody. Take what I need to take. I'm out of there. That sounds like a plan to me.
All right, kid. Drop me at the hospital right here. The office is across the street. Okay, thanks for the ride, kid.
Thanks, Maria. I'll see you.
So I gotta remember the buttons. I remember everything. Not in the Stacy's. Are you a boat, man? There we go. Checkpoint.
Yeah, I'll believe that when I see it. And I pipe down while I finish my book.
Raspberries. I'm gonna go make the rounds.
I'm not supposed to kill nobody, though. That doesn't even matter. Is he above me?
Okay, this is the director's office. This is where the key should be. All right, here's the key. Now I gotta get to the safe.
You got any plans for the weekend?
Yeah, gonna relax.
In to go his way. I know what he circling around. Go open every door, like.
Put yourself a television with it.
This is the Empire Bay Police Department. We have you surrounded. Come out with your hands up. If you do not surrender immediately, we will open fire.
It's fine. I'll find a way to get out without killing nobody. Don't even worry about it. Hurry up and go down the steps, around the corner, through the window.
Mary's Uncle Lou passed away a few months back, left us some cash.
And you bought yourself a television with it.
They petty not to have a checkpoint here, but it's cool though. I'll try to book it. Why is he?
This is the Empire Bay Police Department. We have you surrounded. Come out with your hands up.
If
you do not surrender immediately, we will
I'm out of there. Out of there. What is the run button? Why is he skipping? Like, everything is cool. Find the Stacy, baby. I'm getting chased. Out of there. Hey, man, get in the car.
This is where the Kunos hang their hats.
Oh, it's you. Oh my God, I did it.
He's in line. But no one appreciated. Always blue. And no. Always new.
Oh, see, somebody.
Oh, it was planned that they were standing now and then. Before you get.
Like, yeah, want me to play Hitman? Cause I'm. too good at this.
Well, how'd you make out?
Things got out of hand. There's nothing I could do about it.
We had an agreement. Remember? You only get a third of the money if there's any shooting.
Let's see what we got here. Ah, shit.
Something wrong?
You bet your ass there's something wrong. These stamps you took have an expiration date, and that date is tomorrow.
So, what exactly does that mean?
It means they're gonna be fucking worthless. But wait. If you can get them to the gas station attendants by midnight, they'll be able to stamp them and redeem them. You better bring them to every gas station in town. They gotta get there by midnight or we're screwed. If you don't sell them in time, you get nothing.
Wait a minute, that wasn't our deal. You didn't say anything about any expiration dates.
Well, shit happens, doesn't it? Look, you pull this off, I won't forget it, trust me. Now get going. The faster you unload them, the more money you get.
Wait, I just thought about it. Never mind.
Okay, take care.
You want me to figure it out? I can set a waypoint. Thank God.
Hey, interested in buying some gas stamps?
Sure. Just keep this between you and me, all right?
No problem. Just make sure you do the same.
Sure. Sounds good to me.
Bro, we don't need to sit there, have a chit-chat, dab each other up. Hey, bro, how's the kids? We don't care. Bye.
City and are now facing a Japanese occupation force estimated to be 20,000 strong. Early reports have already indicated that this could be one of the bloodiest battles yet seen in the
Pacific. I got some extra gas stamps. Interested?
Yeah, sure. I'm interested.
All right, here you go. Fork over the dough.
Sure. Here's your money.
Thanks, pal. Now forget you saw me.
It's an offline game.
Interested in buying some gas stamps?
Sure. Just keep this between you and me, all right?
No problem. Just make sure you do the same.
Sure. Sounds good to me.
Question, you think I'm gonna make it? Because I don't think I'm gonna make it. I just need a modern game, bro. These cars handling sucks.
Hey, I got some extra gas stamps. Interested?
Yeah, sure. I'm interested.
All right, here you go. Fork over the dough.
Sure. Here's your... money.
Thanks, pal. Now forget you saw me.
When these cops become pockets full of dreams, a universe even with an empty purse.
Listen, I got these extra gas stamps.
Yeah,
you want them? They're
I
yours. Cheap.
Yeah, all right. I'm good with that.
All right, here you go. And keep your mouth shut about this.
Shit. It'll be our secret.
It better be.
Am I even going the right way? Oh my god.
When nature tries,
no way I've been
to I calculate that I can work for my way in golden rod.
He's slipping by. Come on. Jesus. Get a grip, please.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful. But the fire is so delightful. Since we've no place to go, and it doesn't show signs of stopping, and
I'm running out of fuel. Like, now is the perfect time for this?
Now.
Don't even worry about it.
Kiss good night. How are we going out? But if you really hold me home, I'll be warm and the fire is...
Hey, you in the market for some surplus gas stamps?
Sure. Where'd you get them? On second thought, I don't even want to know.
Smart man. All right, now fork over the dough.
Yeah, all right. Just hope I don't get in trouble for this.
Don't worry about it. Just keep your mouth shut. All right, that's the last of them. At least I got some cash. I should head back to Joe's.
Evening, mister.
Full tank, please.
Sorry about the prices, but gas keeps going up. It's tough times all around, you know?
Nah, this game is for real.
Anything else I can do for you?
Thank you.
See ya!
It was for real. I was really running on E.
Best radio news. I'm Lowell Harris. The sky was raining devastation on the Nazi headquarters and surrounding buildings in Berlin just 1 week ago. In a massive show of strength, almost 1,000 17 flying fortresses blanketed the capital of the third. The U.S. Army Air Forces. The German capital is expected to fall into Allied. Radio News. I'm Lowell Harris.
Did he get in here? Anywhere? When he hears a joke, he always cries. John Deere dies. What do you say we laugh? His sad case. Anywhere he goes, let him fall. The books of Edgar Allan Poe, why don't we lose him? Laugh him in the face. Throw him out the window.
Boy, this car got all the speed in the world. When it comes to a tad bit of turning, oh, yeah, flip the car.
All alone, he's the worst man you ever know. He doesn't know how to keep that is. When there's any trouble, how he boasts. He enjoys the graveyard, he loves ghosts. He'll disappear, leave no trace. That old buddy that is, he's got a face.
He's got a handshake.
Jeez. This. Didn't know Joe could even write.
We got another job. Something really big. Stop by Freddy's tonight. Bring a piece and some lockpicks.
Bring a piece and some lockpicks. I'm assuming they're not gonna let me just walk out the crib, you know, in this attire. But it doesn't even matter, though, because we're going to end it off right here. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe because you want to, not because you have to. But I catch you boys and girls later. See you.